Hi, so I'm recording another 30-minute game tonight. I've just had one, but it was very, very brief, very short. So I'm gonna try and get a longer one because I want to get some practice in for next weekend's Congress and get white this time. I just won with black. Feels good. Very quick win for the Scandi. Okay, Sicilian. I'm not a fan. Not a fan. It's gonna be good practice. Okay, I like this variation. I like this variation. Like it more than some other lines, which I'm not gonna say what they are. But I've been meaning to pick up something else against the Sicilian. I've even been meaning to like swap to d4 and play the London system or something. I'm just. Sicilian gives you too much theory, too many tactical positions to get familiar with. But okay, we got a game. Let's see. Should have made some tea, really. Okay, so I can just castle, then rook d1. Looks normal. Yeah, that's good. Bishop d3, c3, bishop c2, d4. It's possible. My repertoire here is not very detailed. Bishop e2. Knight f6. D3 looks too passive. Bishop d3, knight b4. Maybe it's not possible here. Think bishop d3 is possible when you've played c3 already. Yeah, I mean knight b4 is just not nice after that. Bishop c4 looks possible. Not sure if it's any good. Bishop c4, knight to a5. Bishop to a2 can be played. Bishop to d5 can be played. Bishop to e2. Knight to f4. Knight to c3. I guess some sort of weird close position that I'm not familiar with at all. It's possible. So I'm out of book here, as you can tell. My white repertoire doesn't go very deep, which is fine. The question is where to put the bishop. I just take. Take bishop takes. D3. I'm not sure about that. It's not often that I've given up that bishop so that he can take back with the bishop. Don't really like that. So bishop to e2, knight to f6, d3. I'm just gonna play for that and see what happens. Let's go. Let's not spend too much more time. Yeah, black's probably equalized already, by the way. Just with knight f6. But you don't have to get discouraged as white. Just keep playing, stay ahead on the clock, and you'll have your chances. Yeah, so I've vlogged about this yesterday, I think, and since he's not moving, I'm gonna get it on video. But my plan is to fully learn my black repertoires and leave my white stuff. I'm not gonna improve on theory as white, and then I'm gonna compare how my results stack up. So I was just thinking d3 here, because knight c3, I've never really played those kind of positions, and he'll probably play g6, and I'm not sure a4 is a good move there. I think I'm seeing knight to c3 is fine. But I'm gonna play d3. I can still play knight to c3 if I want to. So yeah. Okay, so he is gonna go for that. I could potentially go b3, bishop b2. I have time for that, don't I? My white bishop is a bit ugly, but b3, bishop b2. It looks like it should be okay. I'm gonna go for that. Some weak dark squares on this side, but I have my bishop here, right? That's quick. Knight d2. That position. My rook a2, queen a1. Looks fun. Rook a2, queen a1. I'm not playing in the center there. I mean, he can start taking queen to the center, so. He plays d5 now. We trade. I trade. My dark squares are a bit weak. But I mean, I'm not sure if something like c4 is a good move here. It weakens d4 too much. c4? He pushes, I take, he takes. Three bishops. Got some weak dark squares, but maybe it's fine. Rook a2, queen a1. Rook a2, d5. I really want to let him take or push, so I have to take, right? If he takes, he pushes, my bishop's just rubbish. So now rook e2, knight to b4, right? That's not good. Knight c4, d5, takes, takes. I take, he takes. a5. For knight to b6. Could be okay. Maybe I just do that. Also defends my b2 bishop, so. B5 is good for him. B5, then knight e3, which is where I want my knight fighting for d5. So I think his best move is d5. My light square bishop is pretty passive. It's my worst piece, I think. But it's not the end of the world. I just need to stay ahead in time. It's not increments. As long as I have a reasonable position, try and go into an end game. You never know. Just I'm thinking a5 after this. For knight b6. Just winning the light squared bishop, and then if we can somehow open up the position, I'll hopefully be able to make that advantage count. Okay, so he's saying he wants to give that bishop up willingly. But I mean, what's the problem with knight to e3? Knight to e3 and then knight to g5. Knight to e3, he can move his knight. There are no discoveries, are there? And he's not really getting to push. Is he saying that knight to e3 d5 takes with a knight? Take the bishop. Take my knight, take with a pawn. That could be okay for me, you know? I don't really want to let him take because I take, so that doesn't look good. Obviously, knight to b6, not possible. I want to go for this. Don't want to spend too much time either, so. C2 is weak. I'm not happy with that. So knight b4, c2 is weak. But it's not that weak. So now I want to play knight to g5 maybe. Just trying to get that bishop to move back. D5. Do I have to take? Maybe I don't have to take. Make him play e5. It's doubtful. E5, knight to d7. Doesn't look good. Okay. That's interesting. So, are you really going back on yourself? Knight g5, bishop back. I'm gonna go for that. I mean, maybe I can even play knight to g5, f4. Why not? Weakens that diagonal, but he's not really getting to it. I think I'm gonna go for that. Just that bishop's a bit too active. I even want to just take the knight and then play knight to d5 after this. I can actually do that, can I? I mean, he would take with a pawn, I suppose. If he takes with a bishop, knight to d5 is just good. Looks good. Take with a bishop, takes with a pawn, on the other hand. And he has the bishop pair. He has double pawns. That might not even matter much because he can play f5 next. That's a shame. That is a shame. Yes, I really like Bishop takes, but he's not gonna take with the bishop. That's hope chess, right? He's gonna take with the pawn. He takes with the pawn, though. He takes with the pawn. D5 is weak forever, right? Is that good enough for my dark squares being weak, though? Maybe I just move my knight back to F3, and say, okay, you want to play F5? He will play F5. No question about it. Maybe I can prepare it. Maybe I can prepare that. F4 just weakens the dark squares even more, so I mean, if I ever trade the dark square bishop for the knight, it'll be even more painful. H3, A5, H3, knight to G4, knight takes, bishop takes. Knight takes, that's not good. Right, what would make bishop takes on F6 better if he couldn't play F5? How can I achieve that, can I? G4? G4 just looks ugly. Knight H3. Saying, okay, go on, take it. No, knight H3 is bad. I mean, I want to play knight to F4, right? Maybe F4, you know, just gain some space on that side. Think I'm gonna go for that. It does weaken the g4 square, but it's protected. And I guess f4 knight to h4. No, it's protected. F4 f5. I might try that. F4 f5. Might be bad though. Sometimes I don't pick the best plan in these positions. What else is there to do though? F4 f5. F4 takes away the e6 square from him as well. Maybe king to h1. Just preparing. King to h1, h6. And I might not even get to play that again. I think I'm gonna go for f4 and just. Well, no, f4 is protected though. F4 is protected. So if he plays d5, I can take the knight. He takes the pawn, and I can take the pawn. And it's still protected. Maybe I'll have to. I'll just move this rook somewhere. Rook b1 looks pretty lame. Rook c1 protects the c2 pawn in case it ever needs protecting. It also leaves a2 open though. A2 open. Okay, well, I need to move something because this is getting ridiculous now. So I would love to fight for d5. How can I do that? Cd just doesn't look good. Does not look good. Maybe rook e1? No, because then it doesn't help f4. Okay, well, I think I'm gonna go for f4 and just see what happens now. It's very tough to find a move in this position unless you've had these structures before and you know what to do. I hope I didn't blunder something, but we'll see. Thing is, you have to manage your time as well, so just picking a plan and going for it. Okay, you're gonna come in there, but what? What's the big deal? I can actually just go back. Mean, I don't really want to take, do I? I think he's burrowing down on c2, so I don't want to take that knight. I can't play c3. He's saying that that's a really bad move, c3. I guess he's gonna play knight e6 then. Then I can play knight h3. Knight f3. I mean, I don't really want to take that knight, so maybe c3 is fine. It blunts my bishop, but I think that's okay. He will get the bishop pair though, but that bishop's a bad bishop. It's only bad though while my pawns are on white squares. What about F5? He has too many pieces on F5. Takes, takes, takes. Bishop to G4 is not good. Maybe rook to C1 is good now that he can't use the A2 square. Just adding some extra protection on c2. It looks reasonable. I'm really low on time now, so I'm basically losing because I'm losing on time, especially without increments. So I need to just move faster now. Even if it's a bad plan, I need to make some moves, I think. Okay, not too fast. What about e5? Well, no, he can take. What if he pushes d5? I can push e5. That looks good. Kind of cramps him. Yeah, that was. If he pushes d5, I can just push e5, right? I'm not a fan of my bishop on b2, it's not protected. B5 he can play. H6 he can play. H6. Maybe I can just go back. I do want to play king to h1 now at some point. So this is the disadvantage of not knowing the theory. You're always down on time. Because I'm trying to figure out good moves here, but if he's played this kind of position before, he already knows the good moves. So he saves a lot of time. And then when he does need to calculate, he just has a lot of spare time to figure out the best move. Knight to e6, maybe I have to take. No, knight to e6, knight to h3, right? Knight to h3, f5. It's possible. Knight to e6, knight to h3. From h3 I can go to f2, from f2 I can go to the g4. It looks reasonable. It's a pretty close position. On d5, I'm thinking e5. I mean, now that he, yeah, I think that's probably a good move. Yeah, obviously, I win a pawn, so yeah, he can't do that. Oh, it's getting a bit cold. Back in a second. Whoop. Whoops. Oh, he played something. Well, I mean, I can't let him take because he wins a pawn. Can't really push past because it's unprotected. So I have to take. Looks pretty clear to me. And I'm guessing he's taking back with a pawn. He takes with a knight. Not sure about takes with a knight. Okay, well, I have to take. Have you seen a combination? What's a combination? I mean, here I was thinking takes with a bishop. He takes with a bishop, we already know my plan. If he takes with a pawn, my plan is still to attack the queen. And then maybe I can play knight to e7 check, win the rook. Potentially it's good. I mean, he has a bishop right now. I mean, that's a good plan if this knight is not here on g5, right? On g5, that knight's just weird. Is he gonna play c4 next? C4 takes, takes. I'm not scared. E5 doesn't look great. I really like the look of bishop takes. I just don't like that my knight's attacked after that. Takes, pawn takes, knight attacks the queen. Queen moves to d8, and I don't actually have anything. Okay, queen moves to d8. Same knight moves back to f3. He has double pawns, and I'm okay, right? It's a good little win. So bishop takes, Pawn takes, knight attacks the queen, queen moves. And knight back to f3. Knight to f3, he can play bishop g4 or not. What's my knight on f3 doing? And if he plays f5, I can just play e5, maybe. I think I'm gonna go for that. My dark squares are weak though, really weak. Maybe just play king back just for one move, see what he does. If he pushes though. He can't push yet. I'm gonna put my king here. Let's try and put him out of harm's way. Yeah, I'm gonna do that plan, treating the dark square bishop, then I want the king safe. Maybe a better plan is just to go f5. Yeah. Before he plays e6. Maybe I should have done that. F5, he plays h6, I can go back to h3. Okay, so now I'm not gonna get a little tactic on the queen. Yeah, but what about f5 now? Well, at least I'm getting the bishop pair back, right? I mean, what's he planning with the queen there? Yeah, obviously I don't wanna push the cheap one, but what about g5? I'm gonna go for g5 and see what happens. 9 minutes. He's getting ready to play d5, right? d5? d5, I can just push. So f5, d5, e5. Let's do it. Also, maybe we can play knight to g4 next. Abandoning d5 though. Maybe now c4 is good. Maybe c4 was better. C4 though, I can't take with a b pawn because my bishop's hanging. It does look like black should be okay here, by the way. I don't feel like I've got much, but I'm just trying to stay somewhat close in time. D5 looks good for him, c4 looks okay now that my bishop's hanging. Can I always trade that knight? Yeah, I mean, I can just take that knight now. Because... He never will be able to play f5 himself now, so that's a benefit. Maybe I can play knight to h3, knight to f4 to help control d5. This knight's not doing very much. Okay, so I was gonna go back with this knight anyway. But now I can also play maybe knight takes on f7 and then knight, then g takes and there. Maybe that's something. I don't think it is. Mean, I was always gonna play knight to h3 anyway, here. I'm gonna do that anyway. Takes first better? No. The next move I can take. Takes and then knight to f4. It looks good. What about bishop takes here now? Bishop takes knight to d5, attacks the bishop, moves the bishop back, loses the rook, gives the bishop back. Yeah, that looks good right now. Instead of doing anything with f1, just bishop takes. I don't know, because even if my knight comes to d5, it's not really. I guess he can come to d5 and it's a pretty powerful piece. Good knight versus bad bishop. But I mean, I need to bring the other knight there, so. Bishop takes, pawn takes. I really can't bring that knight without giving up something though. And pawn takes. Pawn takes knight f4. Could work. Could work. I'm a bit nervous on the time. Okay, he's gonna ignore that and push here. So what I was saying is just take that. Maybe that's even better now. Because if I take, he takes, I take with a knight. It's just getting confusing. Whereas if I take first, and then I take, then I'm definitely winning a pawn. At least. Very complicated. I think I should take though. I want to save some time. I didn't really think this through, but. Okay. Yeah, I could take now and then knight d5. I could also take, he takes, and I could win a pawn. Knight g4, 7 minutes 35. Maybe just pawn takes is the best thing though. Pawn takes, attacking the bishop. Oh, just knight. I mean knight d5 then. I want to go for knight d5. I mean, I don't think that pawn is too important because he gets some counterplay. He has some tempo moves with the bishop, but actually I can just gain the tempo back, I think. I just think eliminating the bishop here is better than winning a pawn right now. That's my honest assessment of this, and I hope I'm right. Plus that knight does look good there, so. Bishop pair can be worth more than a pawn, and that's my my reasoning here, I think. I'm also getting nervous about the time, 7 minutes to 13. I've just basically said I'm not really worried about you taking either one of my B or D pawns. I just capture back, and I think that's probably better than opening this up because I mean his pieces look ready to exploit that. I'm not. So I hope I made the right decision there. I just didn't want to open that up. So okay, he says that he's happy to double those pawns. Really? He really happy to do that? Well, now I have to take the bishop, right? I'm just gonna go for it. I can win a pawn, right? If I take and I take and he takes. It looks dangerous for him. So take. He takes on b3, I take. I don't know. Take, he takes, I take with the rook, he takes on b3. I mean, I can take on g6 check, and then bring my queen to h5. And maybe there's mate somewhere there. I take, he takes my knight, I take. And I capture back. It's probably good for me. This is tough. I'm gonna go for that. This is not something you want to calculate with 7 minutes and no increment. You want 20 minutes for this. Maybe he can play f5, but I get an intermediate check, so with some counterplay. I wish I was ahead on time. I'll probably play this better. I don't think I'm playing too bad though, come on. I think strategically looks good for me. I mean, if he takes back with a pawn, I think I have to take on f6. I understand that my rook becomes unprotected and he gets a very dangerous passed pawn. But, I mean, it looks really, really dangerous for him. Maybe I can play like c3 or something. Yeah. If he takes, I think I'm gonna take with the rook, right? I mean, I don't see his. I mean, he has rook to e6, I suppose. But if I trade and then we trade everything, I'm probably doing okay. I have back rank issues, but my knight can always come back and help. If he takes, what about just knight here though? Knight to f4, attacking the pawn and going for d5. Maybe that's better. Maybe it gives him this counterplay. Because he has to defend the pawn. I guess he can just move up the king, but then knight to d5. I'm attacking the pawn again, which he can't defend. It looks like it gives him less play, you know? Knight to f4 if he takes with a pawn. Maybe he can play f5. Takes. He takes. And his pawn is looking like the more dangerous one. Okay, takes knight to f4, pushes to f5, knight takes. Okay, he's gonna take there first. I mean, I was thinking here, and then taking the. It has to be good for me. I mean, if he takes even with a queen. If I just take the pawn first. If I take that first and he still has to capture my pawn, then rook to f6, but he's getting the same old story. I'm gonna go take here. Let's do it. I think that probably was a good move. Because my knight had a lot of possibilities, right? I don't even have to double my pawns if he takes with a king. I can do queen to h5 check. That would be nice. But he's gonna take with a queen. Yeah, and if he takes with a queen, he's attacking b3 twice. It's double-edged though. Very double-edged. I mean, I feel like my king is a safer one. If he takes with a king, I am pretty sure I should play queen takes. Queen check. Keep those pawns. So I'm not sure what he's thinking about. And he's only 2 minutes ahead on the clock now, so that's good. So queen takes. Capture back. And that opens the g file against his king. That's good. I guess king to like h7. Maybe I'll just take once on c4. Really, you're gonna let me play that check? Really? If I take back, it looks a bit tricky for him. He has to take on c1, I'll take back, he takes then. That looks very bad for him, I don't know. I have to take back, right? So he's saying that I'm losing a pawn. Okay, well, your king is open, so let's see. I'm losing a pawn, I'll give it to you. Maybe if he trades and takes the pawn, I can play something like queen to d2, protecting the rook, attacking h6, which is very unclear how he's defending.
That could be a good idea.
Very sharp. I think white is better. I honestly do, honestly. With time. So right now is when I wish I had 20 minutes. Just a good 10 minute think here. You find the best movements. Simplify to a winning endgame. Queen takes b3. Can also move the king away. Can also push f5 or something. F5, maybe rook to f1. D5. Maybe queen to f3. How about queen takes b3 and queen to g4 check. No. No, why not? Just king to h2 looks very safe. Queen to h2 though. Queen to f4. Yeah. Yeah, I think that's good.
But he's not gonna play that. What's he gonna play? So many moves to think about. Oh,
I'm ahead on the clock. That's good. I need to just play fast and maybe the time advantage will help me. So queen takes on b3, which is the most visible move that you might gamble on. Queen to g4 check. King to h8. And then queen to f4, attacking two pawns that's coming with check. That has to be good. That has to be good. Just has to be good. Okay, so he's gonna do that. I had a feeling. So now he's gonna occupy that with the rook, is he? Okay, so I need to, How about queen to f3 for queen to f5 check? He just protects with the queen. Then I can bring my other piece in. I think an endgame is winning for white, right? So maybe here. Is he really gonna protect with the rook? I don't know. If he takes after that though, he takes. No, taking looks like a nightmare for him. Me queen to f4 next. No, queen to f5 check has to be good. Even if he blocks with the rook. Maybe queen rook to c8 infiltrating. You're gonna block. If you block with the queen, that looks bad. I'm happy to trade to an endgame. Okay, really? Oh, can I play like. I can play rook here. That's an endgame, right? Takes. How about rook to f1 though, attacking that weak pawn? Is he saying that he's gonna just play? Nah, I think it has to be good. Queen to c8 check now. Just defend with the rook. I want to repeat once just to see what happens. Really? Can you do that? Can I go here? A very dangerous position. Just one false move, you're dead. Really, is that not checkmate? What am I missing? Well, I mean, he has to put the queen back and he loses, so that's time pressure blunder. I mean, he's lost the queen. Yeah, resignation. So, well, 1911 highest rating, yay. Yeah, that was tough towards the end, but I'm glad to have that in the bag. He finally blunders. Yeah, I think there would have been a time where I would have played worse moves here again. I think I played this end game well. Usually it would be me on the receiving end here. I just refused to trade into a simple end game and tried to find things to complicate his life until he blundered after this. I mean, I'm not sure what he's supposed to do here. Like, looks bad. It just looks bad. Maybe queen to f8. Somehow, yeah, he keeps the game going probably, you know. Yeah, it's not easy to find till it's 30 seconds and not increment, so he wants to play again, but I don't really have time anymore today, and that's it for today. But maybe I should review this game like I've been doing all the other ones. So yeah, I don't know the theory here, so this is probably not the best move. Don't play this. Don't play this again. I mean, I probably play this again, but I'm sure it's not the most critical try here at all. Not that bishop b5 is. And, oh, oops. Sorry, let's go back again. And it was just a normal position, I thought, and I tried to not weaken my dark squares, because if my bishop on b2 disappears, he's gonna get some play on that side. I wasn't sure about this, I thought for a long time. The problem with this move is that it weakens the dark squares a lot. They're already weak, and now they're weak around my king. So maybe there's a better move here, but I wanted to somehow continue an attack, and I like rook c1, very calm. Let's defend c2, not with the queen move. And I'm not sure he should have taken my bishop on e2. That's my worst piece. His knight is pretty well placed. It's attacking c2, and yeah, he takes my bishop on e2, my worst piece. I say thank you very much, and all my pawns are on light squares, or not all, most of them. All of a sudden my position was better, and then f5, just trying to start something. And I think what he wanted me to do here is to play knight to f3, at which point he might win a pawn, but or not win a pawn, but at least give me some weird pawn structure, right? But no, I go that way. He's trying to play on the queen side, which I think is good. And I'm not sure here if this is the best move. I don't know. But my bishop is unprotected. And I wanted to get more control over d5, so I think this is good. And now I like white's position. I just think there are a few problems to solve, but an endgame should be good for me, because his pawn on d6 is weak, he has double pawns. But I was very low on time here, so I'm not sure I found the best plan, but I found a plan. And he had a way to go wrong here, so if he took with a queen here, he would lose based on queen to g4 check, winning a rook. So he saw that. And yeah, here I left the b3 pawn hanging just because I wanted to get my queen around his king. It does seem like my king is a safer one. That's because I have more space on that side. I think my e4 pawn is controlling f5, and moving my queen to f3 is controlling f5. I think that was a good move. Gets my queen out of the rook's path. I mean, I think you should be fighting for the g-file here too, but I wasn't sure how important that is, and that's what he does, so it's probably good. And maybe here he just needs to trade pieces. I mean, I think it's losing for him, so maybe queen to g6. But my king is blocked off. His king can become active, maybe. So it's not all that clear. I think there are more chances to draw for him. Maybe it's losing. Here I think he just goes rook to g8 and he's okay, right? Because I was going to repeat. And this is why sometimes it's good to try and repeat, because maybe your opponent goes wrong, like he did. I mean, I'm not sure that's wrong, but now his king only has one other useful square, which is h7. And that was probably even a better square, you know, because he could then play rook to g7, queen to g7, and yeah, I think king to g7 is a bad move. And I saw that I could pin his queen to the king, and I guess he saw that. But he thought, okay, I'll just move my queen and it's fine. What he didn't see is that he would lose his queen if he moves the queen, because the king has no protection, and yeah, he resigned. Okay, so that's a quick review without an engine. I think it's useful. And that just highlights the plan I'm having. Play white in whichever fashion I can. I know a little bit about the openings there. Not the strongest in the theory, but yeah, finish my black repertoire to grandmaster level, basically. Know all the theory there and I see how it compares, and I certainly think I enjoyed the last game a lot more where I knew the theory. I just we went off the book, but when we went off the book he really messed up, whereas here we probably went off the book in his favor because he knew more theory. So all right, that's that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.